California gold rush town of Grizzly Flats was founded in 1851. People came for the gold, but stayed for the trees. Lumber from lush forests supported Sierra Nevada foothill towns for decades. Then, one August night in 2021, the Caldor fire roared out of the El Dorado National Forest, and in less than 15 minutes, Grizzly Flats was gone. Today, the community's anger is still raw. Many residents blame the U.S. Forest Service for letting a few-acre blaze morph into a monstrous wildfire. In our months-long investigation, we found evidence of mismanagement by the Forest Service and critics who say its outdated tactics and overgrown lands have led to millions of acres and foothill towns burning needlessly. We went to Grizzly Flats to see for ourselves what happened that August night when a wall of fire ripped through town.
I took a couple pictures of my house, knowing that that would be the last time I ever saw it.
You knew that?
Yeah. I mean, when you got hot embers raining down on you, and your friends and family's houses are exploding, and you're listening to it, and there ain't nothing between here and them to stop you, you know your fate.
Candace Tyler's world went up in flames on August 17th. When the Caldor fire tore out of the El Dorado National Forest and burned the family ranch to the ground.
So where was your house?
So right here would have been our bedroom. And then over here, this would have been walking into our dining room.
The Tylers have lived on this hilltop for five generations. Today, their homestead is a charred hellscape. Blackened trees stand like sentinels over a shadow world. For more than a year, the Tylers and their two children have lived in a trailer. More than 600 homes, nearly all of Grizzly Flats, were destroyed in minutes. The Caldor fire would burn for 2 months, scorching more than 200,000 acres and costing $271 million to extinguish.
When it first started, did you have confidence that the Forest Service would handle it, would put it out?
Absolutely, 100%. A 40-acre fire, you can't put that out in the canyon. And don't get me wrong, I lived here my whole life. I know that's a steep, treacherous canyon, but you're still telling me that you don't have the ability and the equipment to put it out? They didn't do nothing. In our opinion, they did nothing to put this fire out.
Caldor started as a small plume of smoke about 4 miles south of Grizzly Flats. It was August 14th, 7 p.m. This was federal land, so the U.S. Forest Service was in charge, responsible for calling in firefighters and resources. We discovered that problems started right away. Maps were out of date. Firefighters had trouble finding the fire. As she was listening to her police scanner, Candace Tyler told us her heart sank.
They're sending them down Caldor Road. Well, it's been washed out for 3 years. How are you going to get a tanker down there? Have you seen the washout? It's huge. It would take a month of Sundays to fill that hole in or cut a new road.
We went to see what Tyler was talking about. Keeping national forests healthy, including maintaining roads, is a big part of the Forest Service's mandate. But we found many roads in the El Dorado Forest were impassable, blocked by downed trees and deep ruts. When Caldor broke out, fire engines had to backtrack, a costly 2-hour delay.
I can't believe it was even happening. It was like watching a slow-motion disaster.
Grant Ingram also was listening to his scanner. A retired fire captain with 35 years' experience, Ingram fought fires for the U.S. Forest Service and for CAL FIRE, California's state agency. Ingram investigated the initial spread of the fire for the local fire district. He believes the U.S. Forest Service management team bears much of the blame.
The leadership failed to give the team on the ground what they needed to do to put that fire out in a timely manner.
You flat out say it's a failure of leadership.
Absolutely. They failed to understand where the fire was going to go. Then they failed to bring in enough equipment and resources to mitigate that fire. And then they failed to protect the community of Grizzly Flats when they knew it was headed that way.
Ingram told us one of the most consequential decisions came in the early hours of August 15th when the fire was still small. At 1:43 a.m., just hours into the fire, the Forest Service shut down operations for the night. We'll be pulling everyone off the line for accountability.